Yes, okay, children. A colorless material comprising the living part of cell, including cytoplasm, nucleus, and other organelles is called protoplasm. Yes, have you clear? So, a colorless material comprising the living part of cell, including cytoplasm, nucleus, and other organelles is called protoplasm. It means all these protoplasm, cytoplasm, nucleus, and other organelles means nucleus, vacuoles, lysosomes, ribosomes, Golgi apparatus, all these cell organelles. So all these cell organelles are present in the cell, including with cytoplasm. The cell contains a fluid-like substance that is cytoplasm. So this is protoplasm. Protoplasm is the colorless material. What is that? Colorless material. A colorless material comprising the living part of the cell, including. So along with this protoplasm, the cytoplasm, nucleus, and other organelles are present in the cell. So here, what is cytoplasm? So the material or protoplasm, the material or protoplasm in a living cell, excluding living cell. The material or protoplasm with a living cell, excluding the nucleus, not living cell, excluding the nucleus. Excluding the nucleus is called cytoplasm. So dear children, here yes, the protoplasm is formed by this cytoplasm. After that, molecules. What is molecules? Molecules means the group of atoms is called molecules. The group of atoms is called molecules. And what is atom? So the smallest particle of a chemical element is called atom. The smallest particle of a chemical element is called atom. Have you clear, children? After that, so like this way, the levels of organization is takes place. The levels of organization is takes place. Next, coming to the point, dear children. Yes, dear students, the organism, what is this? Is organism means life. It's a life, one organism. This organism is formed by group of organ system, group of organs. So this group of organs are formed by organs. This organ is formed by tissue. This tissue is formed by group of cells, group of cells. This is cell. Actually, dear students, you can't see with our naked eye. We can't see the cell with our naked eye. So how can we see this? How can we observe this cell? Yes, we can observe this cell under the microscope. Under the microscope. Okay, dear children, here to forming of the organism, to forming of the life, what is the basic unit? Cell. What is the basic unit? To forming of the organism or life, what is the basic unit? Cell is the basic unit. So cell is the basic unit of life. Cell is the basic unit of life. So what is the basic unit of life? Cell is the basic unit of life. Dear students, today I am going to explain about cell, the basic unit of life. Okay, dear students, today we are going to discuss the topic name is cell, the basic unit of life. Cell, the basic unit of life. Cell is the basic unit of life. Dear children, so here the cell story. So who discovered cell the first time? So one of the scientists, the scientist name is Robert Hooke. The scientist name is Robert Hooke. Robert Hooke. Yes, the scientist Robert Hooke discovered the cell in the 1665. So he observed, he collected, firstly he collected a thin slice, a thin cork from the oak tree. He collected a thin slice or cork. He collected a thin slice and he observed under his own microscope. What he done? Robert Hooke, in the year 1665, he collected a thin slice of cork from the oak tree and he observed in his own microscope. So while he is observing in the under the microscope, some cavities like structures are visible under the microscope. He called them empty spaces. They are looking like this. So he found the like structure. So this structure he called the little room. So in Latin language, so little room, I mean cavities, we call cavities also. Cavities are eight spaces. So he called them cell. What is cell? In Latin language, cell means little room. So like this way, Robert Hooke discovered cell in the year 1665. Before, one of the scientists, that scientist name is Anthony von Leeuwenhoek. He was the first person to observe microorganisms under the microscope. Anthony von Leeuwenhoek in the year 1674. Anthony von Leeuwenhoek was the first person to observe microorganisms under the microscope. He collected a pond water and he observed this pond water under the microscope. He collected a sample of pond water and he placed the pond water, drop of pond water on the slide, and he added glycerin and safranin and he observed under the microscope. Finally he discovered, he was the first person to observe the microorganisms. What microorganisms are observed by Anthony von Leeuwenhoek? Bacteria, protozoa, red blood cells. So these are observed by Anthony von Leeuwenhoek. How these scientists are observed microorganisms? So these scientists are observed microorganisms under the microscopes. Dear children, there are three types of microscopes. I will tell you. A simple microscope discovered by Anthony von Leeuwenhoek. There are three types of microscopes. They are simple microscope, compound microscope, electronic microscope. The simple microscope is discovered by Anthony von Leeuwenhoek in the year 1674. The compound microscope is discovered by Zacharias Janssen in the year 1595. And electronic microscope was discovered by Max Noll and Ernest Ruska. Max Noll and Ernest Ruska in the year 1931. So by using these microscopes, the scientists are observed unknown world, I mean the microbial world under the microscope. Today we are, nowadays we are learning about microorganisms. different microorganisms structures and their functions with the help of microscopes. So they studied, they worked, they done hard work to know unknown world and microbial world with the help of microscopes. So and next children, simple microscope, compound microscope and electronic microscope after. And next, the cell theory. What is? The cell theory is proposed by Sneden and Swan. Sneden and Swan. There are two scientists, two German scientists. Who are they? German scientists. The Sneden is the botanist and Swan is the zoologist. Sneden is the botanist and the Swan is the zoologist. Yes, Matthias Sneden is a German botanist and Theodor Swan was a German zoologist. So both scientists, Matthias Sneden and Theodor Swan, proposed a cell theory. What is cell theory? So Matthias Sneden is the German botanist, means botany, the study of plants is called botany. And who are studying on the plants? Those are botanists. German botanist. He was a German botanist. He studied on plants as Theodor Swan was a German zoologist. The study of animals is called zoology. Who are studying on the animals and animal behaviors is called zoologist. So this Theodor Swan studied on animal cells. So like this way, both scientists are formulated the theory. What is the theory? Cell theory. What is the theory? Cell theory. So the cell theory is formulated by Sneden and Swan. Okay, the study of cell is called, the study of cell is called cytology or cell biology or cellular biology. The study of cell is called cytology or cell biology or cellular biology. Okay students, yes, this is the today our topic. If you have any doubts, ask me. Okay, I will meet you in the next. I will meet you in the next class. Okay, before leaving the class, okay, dear children, 350 years ago, the microscope was discovered. So all 350 years onwards, they are studying. They are always trying to know the unknown world. The number of scientists are trying to know about unknown world. I mean microbial world under the microscope. Some of the scientists are here. So Athanasius Kircher and Johannes Wobbledon, Antoine van Leeuwenhoek and Robert Hooke. So Athanasius Kircher, Johannes Wobbledon, Antoine van Leeuwenhoek, Robert Hooke. Number of, not only this, number of scientists are worked with the help of microscopes to know the unknown world, I mean microbial world. So more than details about all these scientists, I will explain in the next class. Okay.